At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Exciting men's action coming your way as the Panthers are getting ready to take on the Indians. As I saw some of my dear friends from ALCORN State, I came in with a very thespianistic, Daryl, a DJ, a thespianistic greeting for them. I said, hark. As I stand atop the pinnacle of Prairie View A&M University, the John B. Coleman Library, I see Braves afoot. like we're in some type of movie or something. Well, the Panthers are really coming off of a rough road week, folks. Coming off of a rough couple of weeks, the Panthers have dropped four in a row. Or, pardon me. The Panthers have dropped five in a row. The Braves of ALCORN State have won four in a row. It's going to be a tough contest for the Panthers. If you look at the standings, well, the Panthers pretty much mathematically out of it going to the tournament. But you never know. We've got two more games to play. And as we were sitting down trying to break down what's going on, we had some issues and some questions about if the Panthers continue to win, if they lost a couple of games. It also depends on Texas Southern, depends on some other guys. If you want to just see the standings, folks, you can go to www.pvpanthers.com. Go to www.pvpanthers.com, and you can see our record. If you want to see who is leading in the Southwestern Athletic Conference, all you got to do is go to www.swac.org. If you go to swac.org, go down the left side, drop down box, and you'll go to men's basketball. And then right across the top, they've got it very convenient there on the SWAC.org webpage. News, schedule, standings, statistics, media center. They even got NCAA statistics and archived statistics, all-time champions, and then, of course, the tiebreaker policy in the event that there's a tie, the policies on that. So it's really broken down well for you. Just go to www.swac.org and you can pick up all of this information, and then just go in and click standings, and you'll see the Grambling State's atop of the Southwestern Athletic Conference with a record of 11-3. Men, they're doing a great job down there at Grambling. Congratulations to their both of their men and women's program. Texas Southern is right behind Grambling at 10-4. Southern is right behind Grambling at 10-4. Louisiana winning this year. Texas Southern is third. ALCORN State, 9-5, sit in the fourth spot. The fifth spot's entertained by Bethune-Cookman. Sixth is Jackson State. Seventh, Arkansas Pine Bluff. And in the eighth spot is a tie between Alabama State and Alabama A&M. Prairie View sits right up under that. Both teams would have to lose both games this weekend for us to lose. Like I said, the Panthers pretty much mathematically out of it. So, you know, we're not going to just lay down here. We're going to bring you some more exciting Panther basketball right here in the William Nix Center. Here's the starting lineup for the ALCORN State Braves, starting at forward/guard. A junior from New Orleans, Louisiana, Michael Pajo, starting at point guard for the Panthers. Another senior from Louisiana, New Orleans, Louisiana, Jalen Hawkins at the forward. Well, a transfer from right here in Prairie View getting the start. Jeremiah Gambrell, who went with Bussey. And then Jeremiah Kendall, a senior from the Bronx, New York, all getting the start for Coach Landon Bussey, the former assistant coach to Byron Smith. So, teacher, pupil. How about that? Did you get it, or were you listening? You wasn't. Okay, so he used to be his assistant coach here. Just kind of breaking it down for Mia. All righty then. So the all right, ladies and gentlemen, going to center court. Here's the starting lineup for the Panthers. Starting at guard, Kevin McCaskey, the junior from Missouri City, Texas. Lane, Miles, Smith, and Hopkins. You know, that's our start. That's our five there. So we're going to hope that Miles and the crew can get a win here tonight. Finish the season off right. Miles will be at center court jumping with Michael Paju. And here we go. Of course, we expect Miles to win this one. And our expectations were a little lofty. All right, the Braves will start it off, ladies and gentlemen. Up top with the ball is Jalen Hawkins. Hawkins down low, all the way real quick, easy one, Jeremiah Kimbrell. Kendall. Can't find a hole. And here come the Panthers. Lane over to McCaskey and Hopkins running into each other. Here's Miles there on the left elbow there with Kendall. That should be an interesting matchup. McCaskey for three starts off the bleeding for the Panthers. Jalen Hawkins going at it with McCaskey. Or Byron Joshua, the point guard, and McCaskey fighting for it. Here comes Hopkins on the baseline. Thought about it. Stopped. Gave it back to McCaskey. Miles can shoot the three-pointer and slows it down. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Plenty of time. Hopkins here on the wing. Hawkins on Hopkins. Here comes McCaskey with a double pump off the glass. He's going to be fouled. That's the first one there on Michael Paju, he's French. Now, unless you've had some classes from Miss Baker at Houston Madison, Paju. There you go, Paju. Can you say that, ma'am? There you go. Very good. Mia Greer is going to be fantastic. And next year, y'all guys are going to be like,
well, she's come such a long way.
18-46, McCaskey puts the second one in the hole. Byron's already up off the bench. Not a happy camper. Oh, well. I want to say hello to Tilda Young, who's watching along with CJ. Up top with it again is Joshua. Joshua will bring it down to the right side and try to find somebody coming through. Great hand by Byron by Miles. Ooh, Miles travels. Gets it over now to Smith. And now McCaskey will go up top and fight. Hopkins looking left side. Coming around to the left wing with 12 seconds on the shot clock. Hop with two. Or call it three. The Panthers back on the 22nd of January. Was that the 22nd we played Alcorn? Yeah. Kind of had it rough down there in the sticks, folks. And dropped that one by 22 points. The Braves all over the Panthers. 8-2. The Braves finally get on. Here come the Panthers again. Left side with it, Lane with a dribble drive and double pump partially blocked by the Braves, and we're going back the other way. Kendall got a piece of it. And here we come left side, and Joshua puts it in the glass. Nobody stopped the ball. McCaskey to run the point. Right side, Hopkins for another three. Hits the side of the iron. No good. Going way up to get the rebound. Jalen Hawkins. And here come the Braves. 16:50 left to play. Nearing the first timeout. And Jalen Hawkins rolls one in. Braves cut the lead to two really quickly. McCaskey for three looks good. Boom. Yeah. Keep him off balance like that. McCaskey's on fire. .1626 left to play in the third, and an answer from Hawkins is no good. Here we go back the other way. McCaskey bringing it up right side. McCaskey for another three-point shot. That's four attempts. Two of them are good. And here come the Braves. Oh, great block that time by Hopkins, who just kind of hung in the air with him, checking in for the Panthers. Number 25, Chris Felix Jr., a sophomore from Houston, Texas, and the Alley Cat. Offense for defense. And here we go. That's why. Here we go. The Alley Cats just checked in for us, folks. Andre Nunley, the graduate student from Euless, Texas, will come in and run the point. Here we go, right side lane coming to the right corner. Gets it down low to Miles, but for an easy one. Mismatch under the bucket there with Paju and Miles, and the Panthers score the bucket, 13-6, 7-point edge. This is going to be a battle down here. Bussey going up against Teacher. Kendall has it on the right side, wants to challenge Brian Miles. Miles comes up the victor as the Alley Cat Nunley gets on the ground to get the ball. Nunley bringing the right left side over now to Lane. Lane puts up the 20-footer, no good. We're going back the other way quickly. Here comes Joshua back out now to that time to DeKedrian Thorne, who snuck in on us. I didn't see Thorne. Thorne, the senior from Houston, Texas. Nunley comes right side. He's trapped. They give it over to Hopkins. There's a man open now. Hopkins with the dribble drive puts it up. He's going to be fouled there that time by DeKedrian Thorne, who just checked in. And that's going to take us to the first media timeout, ladies and gentlemen. Hey. It's really interesting here in the Baby Dome. The Panthers up by 7, 13-6, 14:34 left to play. Stick around. We'll be back with more.
The 2024 Starry Swag Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top eight teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers are starting off pretty good here in the first half. 4 of 8 from the field to shoot 50%. The Alcorn State Braves, 3 of 9 from the field to shoot 33%. The Braves, though, with the quicker guards, winning the battle of the paint here in the early going, 6-2. 6 points. To two. The Panthers on their side of the ball. Here we go, right side, Nunley. Coming over right side, Lane under the bucket for two. .1417 left to play here in the first half. The Panthers coming up with it. Here comes Joshua, almost has it stolen. Nunley all over him. Left side, here comes DeKedrian. Thorne, and he'll put it up for two. Thorne actually gets it over to Kendall, and he'll put it in for a five-footer. 15-8 to score. Here comes Prairie View A&M. Right side with it in lane. Gets it back over to Miles. Miles thinking about the five-footer. Gets it on in the corner now to Nunley. Nunley slings it way over to Hopkins. Here comes Hopkins. Dribble drive. Right in the paint from five. In and out. And yes. And in for two. Hopkins on fire here. Leading the Panthers with 7 points. And Charles, you put the wrong live stats up. Right here. And another steal by the Panthers. That's four steals by the Panthers. Nunley tries to steal it. Left side to Kedrian Thorne for three. No. And Felix all over the back, and we're going back the other way. Here comes Smith and McKinley waiting in the wings for the Panthers. 17-8, the Panthers up here looking pretty good. With 13 minutes and 18 seconds left to play here in the first half, coming up at halftime, we'll honor the 10-year anniversary of the Southwestern Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Champions, the Prairie View A&M University Lady Panthers. Here comes Lane way up top. No foul. Yeah, we're going to get a foul with that one. And here comes McKinley off the bench. Great basketball family, that McKinley family. They're at every game, and that foul is going to go against the Kedrian Thorne. And here comes Charles Smith, the fourth. Prairie View Panthers looking pretty good here in the early going there, Mimi. 12 minutes, 58 seconds left to play. Well, we got a little second or two with the free throw shooting. I want to remind you on this Monday, the Panthers host the season finale. It'll be senior night for the men. And the Jackson State Tigers will be in town. And then, of course, the Panthers will be off to Texas Southern this coming Saturday for more action, and think we're going to go to that game. You'll go home with your parents, and we'll meet us at Texas Southern, or are you riding with the big dog? TSU Prairie View at TSU. Have you ever been? No, because you're a freshman and you've never played basketball. Here we go back to, well, not played, but you've never been to a PVTSU game as a student. Here we go, right side with a dribble drive straight to the bucket. Goes Wyatt. And we'll go back the other way. And good defense there by McKinley Harris. Blues a delay game on zero. Well, McCaskey's not out there, they're going to call a delay a game on McCaskey. First warning, 12:39 left to play here in the first. Here we go, left side, McCaskey looking down low, can't find anyone. Hopkins wants it. Hopkins looking for Smith, crossover dribble, looking right side, takes it with the left hand, three-point shot off the back of the iron, no. Jalen Wyatt coming left side, Jalen. Working hard. Also, just checking in the game, Jeremiah Gambrill wasn't in the game in the beginning. Gambrill for three. No, and we're going back the other way. Here comes Hopkins. And Hopkins gets his own rebound, puts it up with a double pump. Man, he can hang in the air, boy. And it's a mad scuffle for it. The Braves win the battle. And here we go, right side. And there's a traveling call. He traveled. Come on, Rev. Golly, Gene Willikers, Stephen Bird. Skip to Malou, my darling. Check it out, folks. Here we go. There's the rebound. They get it out here to Wyatt. Wyatt back over left side. Gets it to him. And Bird just falls out of there as we get ready to go to our second media timeout, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers, man, golly gee, Willikers really got to get it together here. I think we're going to be all right, though, if we can just keep this lead here. Stick around, folks. We'll take a break here. Media timeout on the floor. 11:45 left to play. The Panthers leading 19-8. We'll be back with more.
Yeah. Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you could take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Welcome back to the William Nick Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter, Donald Carroll, and Mia Greer, the Panther sports broadcast team, coming to you one man down. I want to send a shout out to JT Barrett and tell him what a fine job he did with our halftime show the other day. We're going to have to maybe move JT around. Well, of course, we've got to talk to the boss, James. He makes those decisions, but I think there's a little room for him to run his mouth with the big dog. I don't know. We'll check it out. Free throws away. It's good. As we said coming in, the Braves doing pretty decent. The Prairie View Panthers and the Braves kind of right neck and neck with free throw shooting percentage. Now, the Panthers at 72%. The Braves at 73%. There's a one free throw difference coming into this game. 73.4, 72.5. Isn't that interesting? I can do my homework. Here we go, left side with it. Lane was trying to, well, not Lane, but Smith was trying to get it in to Miles, and now here comes Gambrell to bring it back out with the energy for Alcorn State. Gambrell working on Hopkins, the pick set up by Thorne. Now Thorne with it again, kicks it back up top, and we'll set it all over again with Wyatt. Wyatt at the top of the key. Hopkins fighting through the pick, pushed off, and they're going to, yeah. He pushed off with that left elbow, and that's going to be a charging violation against the Braves. The Alcorn State Braves with three team fouls, thanks to Rick Godfrey. The Panthers with one. Seven, as you know, we're shooting the 1-1, 10, we're shooting two. Right side with it in the corner. Miles almost loses it. Gets it back over to McCaskey. McCaskey looking right side. Wants to challenge Willie Anderson Jr., who snuck in on us. Here we go. Right side. McCaskey thinking about the three. He's got two of them on the night. Here comes Lane. Lane with a double pump. Puts it in the left hand. Off the glass for two. Oh, man, that's nasty. Wow. That's what I'm talking about. That was a heck of a call, too. Thank you. 10:38 left to play here in the first. The Panthers on top of the Braves by 11, 21-10. Baird with it at the top of the key, and something's going on, some pushing and shoving. Hey, some pushing and shoving under the bucket. Orlando, oh, check that. That's DeKedrian Thorne pushing. Byron Miles, HR pushing stuff. He better stop it. 10:23 left to play. That was really corny, wasn't it? But I thought it was funny. Wow. Want to send a shout out to the Bishop. He's checking us out. EU. I'm going to have to talk to Rick Godfrey about you, Bishop. Here we go now. Right side, Smith from the right elbow for two. Want to thank you for watching and supporting the big dog so much. 10-10 left to play, 23-12, or 10, 23-10, a 13-point lead by the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University. Here we coming around the right side. Wyatt gets it back over to Gambrell. They drop it down low now to Deja Bennett from France. Okay, we hope we're saying that. Deja Bennett from Nice, France. Here we go, right side, McCaskey now gets it back over to Hopkins. He's wide open from 20, no. And then the cleanup is Byron Miles. DeJay Bennett, a 6'7 junior from Nice, France, by way of Jackson, Mississippi. I thought you'd like that, but did you? Up top, right side, here comes Gaines, Wyatt. White coming around the right side. Oh, man, and some good defense. Here comes Charles Smith over to help. And I want to send a shout-out to Elise Kilbert, DJ, who is she's probably, if she's not with the team at Texas Southern, she's at home watching the Braves after watching husband Nathaniel Kilbert kill the Panthers by two. Right side with it. Off the glass for two. Here comes the alley cat, Andre Nunley. Somebody needs a breather. Left side with it, Lane. Going around the pick set by Miles. Here comes Lane on the baseline with a nice long free throw. Oh, and Smith couldn't grab the ball. Oh, but Miles gets it and says, boom, boom, a boom. Shakalaka. I've been wanting to say that and try that excitement. Didn't like it that much. 8:31 left to play, 27-15. Man, the Panthers looking pretty good. Where's this man? Gambrell now. Brings it to the forecourt. It rolls out. Miles snatches it away, but it's taken away by Baird. And Baird kicks it all the way back up now to Wyatt. Wyatt looking right. Trying to work on McCaskey. McCaskey on him like a jersey. And a reach in on McCaskey. That's going to be two fouls for McCaskey. Yeah, you got all in his grill here. Here, check it out. Here comes Wyatt. Turns left now. He's going to push his hand. See, grabbed him on the jersey there. That's what they call. And you're not even watching. Okay, 8:07. Left their play to give it back into the hands of Jaleek Gaines Wyatt, a freshman from Wyandotte. Is that Wyandotte, New York? Shame on me. Double pump off the glass. I knew that one was good when it left his hands. Here comes Nunley now, 27-17. The Panthers up by 10 right now. Right side, Lane finds a lane with a double pump off the glass for two. Alex. Alex Kosinkovic in the game now for Coach Landon Bussey, the junior from Minsk. Belarso. And the Panthers with some good defense were coming back the other way. 7 minutes left to play, 29-17. Byron wants to repay his pupil for the spanking earlier by 22 this year. Up top, Lane has it coming right side. Here comes McKinley Harris. Harris been working on that 20-foot jump shot before the game for what, 7 games? Oh, and what's going on? Who's not getting some spacing? And Hopkins comes from behind and slams it to the backboard. And, man, the Panthers are starting to get with it. Here comes the replay. No replay. Well, we'll stick around, ladies and gentlemen, and come back with more exciting Panther basketball. This is the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network live on YouTube.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Yeah.
We're back live here in the William Nick Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter coming to you solo. My friends on the Splendid Media Live said, move your face back from the screen a little bit. 6:42 left to play here in the first half. 29-17. The Panthers on top of the Braves of Alcorn State. Thank you there, Key. Kasakovic. Let me see what rain. Let's see. That's going to be one on Harris. Let's see if he does it. Let's see if he. That's not correct. Shot is way no good. Hits the side of the iron. He's 6'7". He's a big kid. Kasankovic. Shot is way, it's good. 6:36 left to play. 29-18 quickly down the left side. Lane turns around, fires it up. Miles. Way up top, quick shot. Come on, Animal. Come on, McKinley Harris with some great defense here for the Panthers. And Lane and Smith will both come out and take a break. Here comes Harris along with the Alley Cat. Joshua brings it up now to Hawkins, and Hawkins gives it back up to Gambrell, who brings it around the left side. Back over to Joshua. Joshua coming right, cut off, great defense to kick it in the corner. Here comes Hawkins. Hawkins cut off on the baseline. Great defense to get it down low to Tashakovic. And back out for a three-point shot, and McCaskey and the Alley Cat collide. But the Panthers keep the ball here, 5:52. McCaskey looking left, brings it right, finds a hole. Oh, with a double pump, gets it over now to Lane. Lane dribbles, misses it. Ah, and a tie-up. No, let's see what's going on. A tie-up, the possession arrow stays down here with the Panthers, and everybody's all over the floor. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 Swackians on the floor. Can we call them Swackians since they're all playing the swag? No? Okay, Swackians. Swackians with swag. Okay, we'll take that, folks. 5:39 left to play, 29-18 to score. Man, just so many accolades, so many wonderful people, so many parents that have come here for senior night. Really made us feel good, folks, telling us how much they enjoy the game. As Smith takes it to the baseline. He's caught off. Now to give it back over to Hopkins. Smith goes back into the corner. And the lane violation, and they right back out. Offense for defense. But I want to just thank all of the folks who watch Panther Vision. And, you know, good or bad, we want the comments. We have all the comments hadn't been good. I'm just going to say. All the comments hadn't been good. We want those comments so we can get better. Because we want to be number one. I'm sure James Crenshaw agrees with that. Here we go back down to the left side, or make call it right. Up top, Joshua has it. Gives it up to Kendall. Kendall, right side, wide open for three is Hawkins. Man, he's way off. And chasing it back down is going to be Gambrell for three. Now, Gambrell looking for his partners. Over here, ex-players and Gambrell. And as soon as he did this and kind of mean mugged the crowd, did you saw that? What did they? Yes, Gambrell played here last year. And Gambrell, here he comes again. And, Hedrick blocked with a double pump. All of that grilling with no grill. You know what I'm saying? He's grilling with no grill there. And coach don't play that. He said, hey, man, sit down. Hey, man, I love Coach Byron Smith, man. Don't he look like your daddy about to give you a whooping? Coach Smith, I know. Boy, I tell you. Here we come, right side. Gambrell for three. Oh, no, they call it a golly gee. Well, it's Gambrell. Lane's going to pick up a foul. That's going to be his first foul. They're going to call that one on the floor, and they're going to give him three shots. If we can run that back, can we run that one back? Let's see. Gambrell's at the line. We don't care. I'm just teasing. Gambrell's a great player for Prairie View. 29-21, and here's the first shot. Now, the Panthers, like the women's team, with a decent lead, are letting the Braves climb back into this one. Gambrell again puts it in for another free throw, and he'll have one more. Baird will check back in with the for the Panthers, along with Wyatt. Gambrell shot is away, and he's going to miss it. Only gets two, but Takedron Thorne gets the rebound, and he's going to be fouled. And now that's a ticky-tack foul, and here we go. On one possession, we're going to give up 4 points. Here's the free throw. Thorne gets it, turns, yeah, and Miles got him with a body. And that's going to be 15 fouls against the Panthers, 4 on the Braves side. And with that 62% free throw shooting, or 73% free throw shooting, is 72 is the Panthers. Okay, I had it backwards. 72.5 for the Panthers, 73.4 for the Braves. So they are a free throw and a half better than us. Well, you made straight A's this semester, so can't do no straight A math for us. All righty, 4:39 left to play, nearing the final media. McCaskey skips it right side. Smith back to McCaskey. Hopkins in the corner. There's the throw. Hopkins with a double pump. He wants the foul. Does a great job of getting to the bucket and drawing fouls. Oh, Gambrell with one high off the backboard. And Gambrell chases down his own rebound. Here comes Takedron Thorne, who puts it up off the glass. No good. Thorne tips it back up. No good. And coming down with it is Joshua. .358 left to play, getting queued up, folks. We're going to let you stay here during our halftime. We're going to celebrate the 10-year anniversary of the Prairie View University Women's Championship basketball team right here at halftime. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball after these important messages.
The 2024 Starry Swag Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top 8 teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with 2 NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter, along with Donald Carroll and Mia Greer, bringing you exciting action live from the William Nix Center. 3:56 left to play in the first half. Ta'Kedron Thorne with a nice turnaround in the lane for two. And now the Panthers have let the Braves eat into that gap, 29-24. McCaskey got off to a great start with a couple of threes, but has been quiet since. Gives it up the lane in the corner, wide open for three. Lane, no. Great job by Harris of knocking it back into the hands of McCaskey. Lane with another one. Puts it off the back of the glass, no good. And McKinley really going after it with some great defense.
All right, Panthers. Defense. Defense.
Oh, I'm ready. Yeah.
Defense.
Defense. I'm showing her. Hurry, okay, I got you. I got you. 3:21 left to play. Folks, we're going to get out of here pretty quick for the halftime. Don't have a lot of time. And another. Well, 29-27. The Panthers led by 14 points here and have let the Braves battle back into it, kind of similar to what the women did tonight. McCaskey has it right side. He hit a couple of threes from right there. McCaskey with the dribble drive. Thought about the drive. Kicks it back out to Lane. Lane comes back right side with a double pump. And Lane is octopused by, if you're looking at that one, by Thorne. Got his tentacles all over him. Lane's shot is away, no good. 2:44 left to play in this one. Smith will come back in, and the Panthers taking a long walk down, 29-27. The Panthers with the ball now. The Braves now in the 1-1 with 2:32 left to play. Lane brings it right side. Finds, and just good defense by the Braves of staying in front. A double pump from Joshua, and it goes back the other way. The Panthers want to win this one. All right, folks, here comes McCaskey down. Close to crunch time here in the first half, folks, nearing 2 minutes. Miles pushed to give it over now to Smith. Smith steps back, all kinds of fouls on Smith, and they give it to McCaskey. McCaskey with 13 seconds finds a lane, puts it up with a reverse layup, gets his own rebound, throws it back out to Lane. Lane on the baseline with a double pump, puts it up off the glass, no, and he's going to be fouled. We'll go to the line. Harris getting back out there. Michael Pejo will pick up his first personal. That's eight team fouls. However, that one's in the act of shooting, so we got a couple. Shot is away. It's no good. Want to send a shout out to my main man, Eric Juarez. Didn't see you last week. I'm looking for you Wednesday, Eric. As Lady Panthers get ready for some exciting softball. Shot is away. It's no good. In and out. A minute 43 left to play. Golly, gee willikers, how you going to miss two free throws? Thorne has it at the top of the key, wants to work on Miles. Has it knocked away. Gambrill picks it back up, kicks it in the corner. Here comes Thorne on the baseline, and a nice knockaway. Can we call that one a knockaway from Byron Miles? .121 left to play in the first half. Way out now to Kendall. Kendall back to Gambrell with a turnaround three. And Harris can't hold on, and it's going out of bounds. It looks like the Panthers. That one looked at it like it really went out on McKinley Harris with some great defense. Good defense by Harris. That's my man there. Felix Jr. will check back in. Chris Felix Jr., sophomore from Houston, Texas. And also checking in for the Braves, Willie Anderson Jr., a sophomore from New Orleans, Louisiana. 1, 2, 3, 4. Vicksburg, 5. Bussy spent a lot of time in New Orleans. Lane gets it back right side to kick it left now to Hopkins. Hopkins to Lane for two, finally. Lane now gets off of that scoring drought. Under a minute here with 31-27 to score. Gambrill for three in the corner. And now with 32 seconds left to play, the Panthers are up by one with 32 seconds, a 2-second differential on the shot and play clock, a 2-second differential on the shot and play clock. We'll take our final timeout here in the William Nix Center, folks. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball after this quick break.
There we go. All right. Let's keep it smooth.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Jim Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen, 29 seconds left to play. I tell you, these students, we live. I'm doing good, ma'am. Here we go, McCaskey now bringing on the right side Lane. Back up top now to Hopkins, down 18 seconds. The Panthers trying to play for the last point. Here comes McCaskey. Shoot it down over to Miles for the funky dunky under the middle. Everybody spreading out. And coach wants a timeout. And down to 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Deep three-pointer. And the Panthers get out of that one, ladies and gentlemen, with the lead 33-30. Stick around, folks. We'll go to our studios for halftime, ladies and gentlemen, and come back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View University Panther Sports Network.
Can't get enough, can't get enough. East side, west side, worldwide. Ride out. Nah, I ain't got no kids yet, but this right here's for practice. I hate to get the seats in the bins wet, but that's how good your ass is. Make an old man get his glasses, make Wesley pay his taxes. Then follow your moves all week on Twitter. Probably make a gay nigga reconsider.
Panther Nation. This is your athletic director, Anton Goff. I want to take a few moments to thank our corporate sponsors as well as our individual donors for your continued support. Our fundraising efforts are essential for our student-athletes to be able to compete in the classroom as well as in their sports. Not only do I want to thank you for your generosity, but I also want to show you what your generosity has produced for a few of our sports.
First of all, the Department of Alumni Affairs, Ms. Phyllis Darden Caldwell, our Athletic Director, Mr. Anton Goff, our Senior Women Administrator, Ms. Alicia Peet, and you, the fans here at Prairie View A&M University. Let's give them another round of applause. Also, Ms. LaTanya Thurston, they had our names on there that day. I didn't call mine, I didn't call yours. One more time, folks, let's give them a nice round of applause. We gotta get it going. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let's go. Come on, let's go.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Goff. I want to take a few moments to thank our corporate sponsors as well as our individual donors for your continued support. Our fundraising efforts are essential for our student athletes to be able to compete in the classroom as well as in their sports. Not only do I want to thank you for your generosity, but I also want to show you what your generosity has produced for a few of our sports. When you become a sponsor or donate to athletics, you immediately become part of our community and a member of the Panther family. You may or may not know, we've had some major renovations for some of our facilities, so I want to let you know what they are. First, here at our tennis center, we've resurfaced every single one of our courts. All 8 courts are brand new, so we have one of the best playing surfaces in the area. Here in our soccer stadium, we redid our turf to not only make it a faster playing surface, but safer for our student athletes. Here we are inside of our softball stadium. Right behind me, you'll see a brand new fence. Not only is it brand new, but we moved it back enough so we can host postseason play. And on opening day, we'll have a brand new scoreboard out here for our softball team. Here we are at our baseball stadium. As you can see, we're on our brand new artificially turf field. This is going to allow us to play more games as well as make sure that we don't have the same wear and tear as natural turf. We're excited about this project and we're looking forward to baseball having a great season. So as you can see, we've been pretty busy around here at PV. All this because of the support you've given us, but we can't stop there. We need your continued support so we can continue upgrading our facilities here. And listen, not only have we been busy doing the facility upgrades, we had a great fall 2023 sports campaign. Starting off, our football team won the Western Division, played in the championship for the SWAC. Our women's volleyball and our men's cross-country team finished second in the SWAC. We had our women's soccer team finish fifth, and we had our women's cross-country finish sixth. A great campaign, and we're looking for a great spring semester right now. We've got our men's and women's basketball team fighting for SWAC championships. We've got our bowling team doing a great job, our tennis teams. And right around the corner, we've got our spring sports. We've got two sports trying to three-peat as SWAC champions. Our softball, as well as our women's outdoor track. And we're excited about our other sports, baseball, tennis, golf, men's track. They're going to be competing for SWAC championships, so thank you for your support. So let's continue our run at the Commissioner's Cup. We are PV, where champions are built and excellence lives here. What's up, Coach?
What's up, Eagle?
Hey, I was checking out this 2024 home schedule. Looking good, man. This is definitely get fans in the stands.
Absolutely. We need fans in the stands, right? To come support our 23 Western Division champions. All right, here. This is where we're going to start it right here. August 31st, we got Texas Southern. You guys know that's going to be a huge game, big-time game. We need everybody out there. Then we jump down to September 21st against Southern. Big rival game. We play them at home. We got them last year. We'll get them again this year. Then we jump down to October 9th. We got a bye. Then we come to October 26th. We got Texas Commerce for homecoming. We know how we do at homecoming. We need you out there. Go back down. We jump down to November 9th. We got Florida A&M. Played them twice last year. All right. Now we got them first this year. Then we go to November 16th. We finish up with Alcorn.
That's a heck of a season. You know, for me, I got to tell you what time it is.
What time is it?
It's time for PV Nation to buy their home season tickets right now, today. Go to PVPanthers.com and buy your season tickets today.
Go, Go Panthers. Panthers.
www.pvpanthers.com. Be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Take pictures, leave messages at PVAMU Panthers. Panther Athletics wants to thank its corporate sponsors, Adidas, Sodexo, Pepsi, and Houston Methodist Hospital at Willowbrook. Support the teams that support your Panthers. Your Panther softball team will be back at the Lady Panther Softball Stadium on March 6th to take on the University of Pennsylvania Quakers. First pitch is set for 2 o'clock. Continue to support your SWAT champion Lady Panther softball. The 2024 Prairie View Relays is back at the Prairie View A&M University campus March 22nd and 23rd.
2024 Starry Swag Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top eight teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen, Charles Porter and the Panther Sports Broadcast Team coming to you live here as the Panthers start off the second half traveling their way, folks. The Panthers leading the Braves of Alcorn State. McCaskey gets it, puts it off the glass, starts it off where he started with 2 points. McCaskey was the first to get on the board for the Panthers in the first half, and now the first to get on the Panthers in here in the second half. 35-30 the score here early in the second period. Panthers with some pretty even numbers as far as statistics is concerned. 11 of 21 in the first half, as the Panthers can't hold of that one. 11 of 21 to shoot 52%. Perfect from the free throw line. And 3 of 7 from three-point range. The Braves of Alcorn State are 32% shooters from the field on 8 of 25. 42% on 3 of 7 from the free throw line. And 2 of 8 to shoot 25%. From the charity stripe. As far as turnovers, the Braves doing a pretty good job of holding on to the ball with 5 turnovers, and the Panthers with only 4. Pretty even in the paint, 16 for the Panthers. We've got Brian Miles and 12 for the Alcorn State Braves. The Panthers with 9 points off of those 5 turnovers for the Alcorn State Braves, and no points off the bench, 6 fast points. And fast break points, and the Braves are winning with second chance points by 1-5-4. Miles' first shot is away. No good. Second shot creeps in for him. 36-30 the score here. And the Knicks center, want to send a shout out to Daniel Osteen, another former Prairie View A&M University men's basketball superstar and my classmate. How about that? Papa Edmund is also watching, along with Dwayne Charleston and Eric Juarez. 18-47, deep three-pointer in the corner from Jeremiah Gambrell, and Lane hits the ground hard. We'll take the long walk. Rondo. Lane to take it out. McCaskey down. Here comes Joshua, or Hawkins, rather. They both go back down. McCaskey right side. Here comes Hopkins. Finds a hole. And he can just hang in the air so long, folks. Great leaping ability. For the Panthers. Great shot and another roll with that from Jalen Hawkins. And here comes up off the bench for the Privian University Panthers. Nicholas Gazelius will come in and get a break. He's a graduate student from right there in Humble, Texas. Is it Humble, Texas? Yeah, Humble, Texas. 38-33 foul. Here's I tell you, Hopkins does just an incredible job of leaning into the defenders with a double pump. Coach Bussey and Andre Payne over there chatting. Andre Payne, former head basketball coach at Mississippi Valley State, who has now joined the Alcorn State Braves team. Braves last year Southwestern Athletic Conference champion. Hopkins puts it up no good. Thirty-9-33, 18:06 left to play. Right side, Joshua has it, looking for Gambrell in the corner. Pardon me, that's Hawkins who has it knocked away. And here comes McCaskey. McCaskey driving, dribbling, under the bucket, looking for Miles. And saved in by the Braves, man, a blown opportunity. Here we come back down on our right side. Brian Joshua skips it down on the baseline to Pauljo. And coming in there, nobody's paying attention. Jalen Hawkins with an easy one, 39-35. Hopkins comes left, finds a hole with a double pump, puts it back up off the glass. No. Lane can't find the goal. Here comes Gambrell. And Gazelius with a good foul. And we're going to go and take a look at the 1-1. What's going on? 11, Gazelius. They're checking to see if it's an intentional foul. That's what it's going to be. They're checking to see if it's a flagrant. And an official review. Folks, don't forget, coming up on Monday, more exciting Panther basketball coming your way as the Jackson State Tigers come to take on the Panthers. A 5:30 women's tip-off and a 7:30 men's tip-off here in the William Nix Center. And then on Wednesday, Mia gets her first taste of softball. You better be there as the Panthers take on the Quakers. They're playing some Quakers. Okay, will they bring oatmeal with them? No, I'm just teasing. I better stop before they come out here and listen to the broadcast, come out with some big bats and really get us, huh? We're still looking at it. And what's the call? Well, what's the call? They're going to give the foul to the Braves, right? And one is going to go to the line. It's going to be a common foul. Okay, so it's just a regular foul. Shot is away. It's good. Now, remember, the Braves not so hot in the first quarter. Shooting free throws. Just threw it away. They were 3 of 7 from the charity stripe in the first half. Here comes McCaskey now. The Panthers only with a two-point edge here. McCaskey coming left side, throws it to over to Miles. He thought about a 15-footer. Now takes it, drives it in, and gets a roll with that. Panthers up 4 now. Left side with it. There is Kendall, and an easy one for him. We got to block that cat out. Here comes McCaskey now at the top of the key. McCaskey coming left, kicks it up now to Lane. Here comes Lane, loses the ball, gets it back right there to Brian Miles. And Miles, standing right where he needs to be, puts it back in the hole for 2. My vote for Brian Miles, big man of the year. And with 16 minutes and 4 seconds left to play, the Panthers up 43-39. Man, going way up there. Nobody's blocking out there. And there's an easy one and a foul. And they're fouling all over the place. Easy foul. Gosh, gee willikers. Smith will check in. Gazelius will come out. And we're going to, before all of this happens, we're going to take a media timeout, ladies and gentlemen. And hopefully we can try to keep that same old feeling going here, ladies and gentlemen. So the Panthers need to keep on hitting some jump shots. 15:54 left to play here in the second period. The Panthers up by 3, 43-39. Stick around.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the Knicks Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter along with Donald Carroll and Mia Greer, the Panthers sports broadcast team, coming from you courtside. Hey, just some interesting statistics. The Panthers shooting 66% here in the second half on 4 of 6 shots. The Braves shooting 50% on 3 of 6. 19-16. How can the Braves be winning the rebounding war with our height there? Second chance points. If you look at them there, the second chance points, the Braves have 7, Panthers with only 5. 26 points for Prairie View in the paint. Most of that coming from Brian Miles, who's on his way to another double-double, 13-6 already. And we'll see what goes from here. And McCaskey with a steal, fouled from behind by 13. Is that Kendall? 1-3. Yeah, Kendall's going to be called for the foul. It's And here comes Hopkins over to McCaskey, quickly up the right side. There's Charles Lane. He thought about that three-point shot. Backs it in. Turns it. Partially blocked. And it goes out of bounds on the Braves. Golly gee willikers. Bussy just can't believe it there. And we're going to reset the clock at 30. 29, rather. Oh, what is it? He said put in that. He didn't have possession. He did not have possession, so they're going to start it at 29. Are we going to watch it? We're going to take a look at it, folks. All right, as they're taking a look at it, folks, we will take another break here, folks, to tell you about what's going on in exciting Panther basketball and exciting Panther sports as the Panthers get ready to entertain the Quakers of Pennsylvania. We'll be right back. We're back live here in the William Nix Center. The officials just trying to make sure that the ball went off on the Braves, and now the Panthers with it with 16 seconds on the shot clock. McCaskey has it, throws it back right side over to Hopkins. Boom. No, Hopkins in and out. Lane gets the rebound, tries to scoot it down to Hopkins. Hopkins gets it back. Hopkins turns with the Euro step off the glass. No, left-handed, and it stays on the Panthers' side. 12 seconds left on the shot clock. McCaskey shoots it in now to Smith with the running hook over to Brian Miles, man. We're going to start calling Miles the cleanup man. Here we go, left side Bowie. Oh, he traveled, yeah, what I was going to say. I was about to say, ref, let me get a ticket too. I mean, gee willikers. Checking in for the Alcorn State Braves is going to be DeKedrian Thorne along with Wyatt. Folks, come out and support the baseball team as they return to the diamond for their home opener this Tuesday, or next Tuesday, actually, March 12th, They'll host Jarvin Christian. First pitch is at 1 o'clock. Of course, our team only doing softball as of now. And here comes Hopkins with a double pump and a foul. On the floor. Or did he get him in the action? And it will be a shooting foul. Hopkins going to the free throw line. Hopkins at the line for free throws. The Panthers shooting a 50%. Half and half, first shot is away, it's good. And Stephen Baird, the junior from Atlantic City, New Jersey, will check in now for the Braves. Well, Mia, that's three teams that have come into the Baby Dome and complimented us, DJ, on our production. We want to thank Nathaniel Kilbert. We want to thank all of the fans down at Grambling State and Southern who couldn't wait to come in and see who is the person that is running this video. That's they wanted to see DJ. That's what it was. 14:26, nearing media timeout two, folks. Here in the second half, 47-39 the score. Gambrell at the top of the key, wants to work on lane, backs it out, gets it back up top now to Wyatt. He'll run the offense. Wyatt comes left side, stutter steps at the elbow, puts it up, in and out, no good. And here come the Panthers. Miles with seven rebounds now over the lane with, a double pump. And, guys, how do you miss that? Gee willikers. Gambrell for three. We know he can do it, folks, and it's knocked around, tipped around, chased down by the Braves. Kendall puts it in for two. McCaskey. And CJ getting a chew here because CJ should have shot that ball. How do you miss an easy one? Here comes Lane to make up for it. High off the glass. Partially blocked. No call by the official. 32 left to play. Here we go, left side. Kendall can't handle it. And we're going back the other way. Kendall reaches in. And that should be enough. Well, is that Gambrill? And we're going to take the long walk down? No, what's going on? Checking in for the Braves, Willie Anderson Jr., the sophomore from New Orleans, Louisiana. That's going to get Kendall a break. Kendall 13. Looks like he's got four fouls. Is that four for Kendall? We'll check it in a minute, folks, and verify. Here comes McCaskey coming left side, finding a hole, backing it out. And here comes Hopkins. Hopkins now from the left elbow puts it up. Oh, man, that's way short. Up top, Wyatt kicks it right into the hands of Baird. Gambrell wanted it, running the baseline. Back up top, right side, Baird hits it for two. 12:33 left to play, 47-43 the score. 47-43 the score. It's got 12 down there, 18. There we go. McCaskey. To Harris, right side now to Smith. Back to Harris, over to Smith. He comes around the right side. Smith back up top. Miles, he'll take the three-pointer. Yeah, he can do it. He's the everything man. He's a new superhero. I thought it was pretty good. I don't know. Here we go, left side. Wyatt comes around. McCaskey, man, I tell you. Harris is going to get an ice bath after this one. That's for sure. Him and the floor are one. Great pass in. Oh, man, to Miles. Caught a birdie named Willie Alexander. And coach said, I better stop this here. I want to stop the bleeding here. Okay, 11:25 left to play here in the second half. The Panthers now starting to walk slightly away. 52-43 the score. Stick around.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. A 10-point difference in the paint for the Panthers and the Braves, with the Panthers winning the battle in the paint by 10, 30-10. The turnovers, the Panthers are capitalizing off of the 12 turnovers of the Braves. They've got 9 points on those 12 turnovers, and the Braves stayed out on their end with Gambrell. Left side, Bowie with it, in trouble, kicks it back. Right side, here come the Braves with a running jumper that time. Thorne with a pretty good shot. McCaskey at the top of the key, kicks it right side over to Hopkins. McCaskey. Coming right side, trying to find some help. Gets it to Hopkins. Hopkins popped in the face. Hitting right in the face. Gosh darn. Timeout on the court. And McCaskey. Here comes Gambrell is the culprit there. And here we go back the other way. And I think Hopkins up off the bench now. Hopkins and Gambrell been going at it the entire game. And Smith is out there tending to a star player. Here comes, well, no more. But they're going to go look at that and see if that is an intentional foul. They're going to want to look at it. And we're going to wait and see, folks. So as they continue to break it down, you can't see it on the replay. But here we go. Now, McCaskey gets it back out. Doesn't really look intentional. DJ, what do you think? You got a mic, man. Talk. You got a mic. I mean, you're the replay guy. So, I mean, you know, I'm sure your opinion is just as good as ours. You do this for a living every week. I just watch it on the weekend. Basketball play. Donald Carroll sitting up. Just a basketball play. No intentional foul. No flagrants. No X-Man signs. No Wakanda signs. just regular fouls. You like it? You got to pay attention. You're missing all of the funnies. No, she. You're over here eye hustling. Oh, okay. Good job. Mia Greer going to get an injury update on Javonte Hopkins. All right. Well, here come the Panthers. Hopkins poked in the eye. Well, I tell you, it was really, really refreshing to see our athletic director in a cowboy hat, and he's from Illinois. And, yo, I ain't never rode a horse before. You got that with DJ because you're old. That's a little Willie D. But we'll leave that alone. Here we go, left side right there, Hopkins over there. Not to Hopkins, pardon me, to Miles, and a double pump. Felix gets it, gets the rebound. Felix working on the baseline, gets it back over now to Lane. Lane looking down low, can't find anyone. He kicks it back up top to McCaskey. McCaskey coming left side. Now in the corner, shoots it over to Felix. Felix over now to Charles Smith. Off the glass, no. Gosh, steal my thunder in that manner. 10 minutes left to play here. The Panthers up 52-45, only a seven-point edge. Gambrell will have it at the top of the key, playing purple in the gym that he made famous in. And an easy pass on the left side. Here come the Panthers. Now we've got to really kind of start matching buckets. Here comes Smith, kicks it down low. Felix with a good strong layup, and Smith goes to the bucket. McKinley Harris has been on the bench for quite some time. Yeah, I'm sorry, folks. Everybody's begging to get McKinley Harris in the game. I'm telling you. And McCaskey says he needs a blow here. And McCaskey plays at a very, very high level. So it's about time for him to get a breather here. Don't forget, folks, exciting Panther basketball comes your way on Monday as the Jackson State Tigers come to town in the season finale here in the William Nix Center. It has certainly been a pleasure all season. We want to just thank so many people for, first of all, allowing us, Mia, to come. And, get a little compensation for what we love to do. And you're going to start loving it more as you continue to deal with my crazy self. Shot is away. It's good. Felix with some good rebounds. Chris Felix, Jr., the graduate student from Houston, Texas. Gambrell back up top now with 9 minutes left to play. They kick it down low on the left side over to Joshua. Joshua coming to the right side with a double pump. Hey, man, high archer. Easy bucket. Nobody's cutting him off in the middle. Man, Byron's not a heavy camper. Here we go. Felix kicks it down on the right side. Gambrill. Oh, great defense. No foul. Great defense. Good job of sticking a hand in there. Felix. Good kid. And Nunley, the alley cat. Will come back out. Gambrell, no clock or something on the floor. You know, the young man who's there under the basket assisting, you know, you give people nicknames there, Mimi, and you forget their real name, but that is just one fine young man, just a good kid. We're going to have to get his name. I call him Bassi, but, you know, his name is – it's something like that, though. I just can't pronounce it. Here we go, left side now. Joshua coming in, some pushing and shoving. Watch it out, White one. That's going to be on that's Charles Lane at Hopkins. Back in the game for the Panthers, Smith. Having a – not the best game. And a foul with the shot. Golly gee. Well, folks, Jacqueline Giles, I want to send a shout-out to you. Tony Runnels is also watching along with Daniel Osteen. I want to thank you guys for watching. 8:28 left to play. The Panthers will take on Texas Southern University down in the H&PE Arena on next Saturday. We are planning to do that game on the Splendid Media Network. We will share that game, the audio, on the Prairie View A&M University Network. So what we're going to have to try to do is get a feed going to our YouTube page. We probably will not be what you get a chance to see here. We're very, very privileged to be able to do it this way as we try to grow this program. And I don't think we'll be able to do this next year. So enjoy it while you can, Panther fans. I mean, when I say do double duty there, along with just allowing you to watch some of the game, along with listen to it. You'll probably only be able to listen on Splendid Media next year. High archer off the backboard is good for Hopkins. 55-51, a four-point lead. A little too close for comfort for the big dog, folks. Panthers have got to do something about it. Lane fighting through the lane. Now Joshua, he's killing us right there. Golly gee, Willikers, can we cut him off? Now there goes the points in the paint here. He's going to account for all the points on his in the paint himself. McCaskey for three. No. Should have been shooting it. Oh, man, a long rebound by Miles. Back out to Hopkins. Hopkins comes right side high off the glass for two. Man, way high off the glass for two. And Bussy says, hey, I don't like this one, Coach Smith. We're going to take a chance and regroup here and come back with more exciting Panther basketball after these important messages. 7:22 left to play. The Panthers up by four.
The 2024 Starry Swag Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top eight teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Working with the working is still, cause I cannot work it more. Soon as I get it, I know it, it'll all be worth it all. I can never quit cause I'll probably start having worry draw. Baby girl, what you doing? Looking on my face, what are you proving? I need to feel your body moving. And like some hoopers, we'll be grooving.
Baby girl, what you doing? Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Just getting some verification from Miss Latanya Thurston before we start giving out any inaccurate information. This is going to be, if tonight will be 13 tonight, if he does, okay, tonight's going to be 13 double-doubles from Brian Miles all year, man. He is a beast, 20 and 10 here tonight. 7:04 left to play. Here we go, left side. Joshua loses it off his leg, and the Panthers get it back. 57-53, a four-point lead. Here comes McKinley Harris and Charles Smith. We're going to try to talk to Coach Byron Smith after the game. You know, when you're riding with someone, you got to shorten your postgame show now. Right side with it. Lane back up top to Smith. Left side now to McCaskey. McCaskey coming back with it. Looks left. Oh, Hopkins in the air again. It's just getting beat up. Between Hopkins and McKinley Harris, I'm wondering who's going to Ben Taub. That's an old school joke. Ben Taub, you really got to know. That's old school. Ben Taub? Hopkins, Ms. Greer says Hopkins is going to Ben Taub today with all of this beating he's taking. I want to send a shout out to Tony Reynolds and Jacqueline Giles who are watching on the Splendid Network. All you got to do is just switch on over to the YouTube channel and you can watch and see it. And folks, I tell you, with all of you watching, just think if all of you just gave $10 to the program, everybody that has watched this year have given $10 to the program. I don't think we have any problems, DJ. I think we're close to, and I'm not exaggerating, close to 50,000 views. No, less or more? Way less. What do you mean, way? No, I'm just teasing. I'll say 20 for sure. At least 20,000 views. We've had 5,000 in the last four games. Okay, so I know we're at least at 20. Yeah, I thought so. Now that you think about it, huh? Miles loves it. We'll go back down the other way. Some good sportsmanship by the Panthers. McCaskey helping up Joshua. That'd be, if everybody gave 10 that's watched, that'd be $200,000. We wouldn't have any problem. We go all over the, we'll go all over the swag. We'll go everywhere. Huh? 20,000 views to give 10 bucks. Mia, you'd get your money. What? If we had 20,000 viewers, we've had that plus for basketball, just for basketball. If everybody gave $10, that'd be $200,000. Huh? Miles is foul going up under the bucket, but Hopkins' chin is above the rim over there, so we – he's way up there. The Bray family. Miles at the free throw line, who's leading all scorers. Well, just a moment ago, he was leading all scorers with 20 points. That would make it 21. Let's go back over here to the live stats, folks, and check it out. If you go to www.pvpanthers.com, scroll down on that main page down midways, and you'll see the schedule. And you'll also see tonight's game. There's three, the hamburger there to the right, three dots. Click those dots, and you can get the live stats. Brian Miles with 22 points and 10 rebounds. Call it 11 rebounds tonight. Gambrell with the quick jumper. He's got that quick release, and you got to stop him. 61-56 the score. The Panthers now need to continue to score. Score the ball. Here comes McCaskey on the right side. McCaskey to Lane. Hopkins is way over here by himself. McCaskey didn't want to attempt the cross-court pass. Now gets it over to Hopkins. Now Hopkins on Joshua. He's been shaking him out of his shoes. Hopkins stops, pops. No. Harris can't swat it away, and here come the Braves. Wide open for three. There was Takedrian Thorne, the senior from Houston. And now here they come. Cut the lead 61-59. McCaskey up top to Hopkins. Hop coming right side. Lane, Miles with it. Over to McCaskey, thought about the three-pointer. Now drives on the baseline. Now kicks it back out now to Lane. Lane looking left. Kicks it over to Harris. He touched the ball. Well, he pushed the ball back in his hands. And Lane is getting a chew for not shooting the ball. Left side with it. Joshua has it now back up top to Pujo. and Gambrill for three. And there are some happy people out there. It's probably Jeremiah Gambrill's mom. What do you think? Yeah. Hopkins. Now to McGaskey, to Lane. Lane stops, spots, nice looking shot. No. Harris can't get a hold to it, and we're going back the other way. Right side with it. Here's Baird. Gambrill up top working on Hopkins. The kick at left side now to Pujoud. And Gambrill drops his shoulder into Hopkins and turns it over. And we're going to take the long walk down now because the Braves are in the penalty. This helps the Panthers out tremendously because now the Panthers will be shooting two for the next 4 minutes and 6 seconds every time the Braves foul. .406 left to play here in the second half, folks. The Panthers with the ball. Here comes McCaskey. Brings it left side. McCaskey shoots it back out the lane. Here comes Lane on the right side. Gambrill takes it away and for an open dunk. Just lays it off the glass for two. The Braves up three now. The Panthers were up by as many as 11. Here comes McCaskey. Hopkins wants to take the shot. Hopkins coming left side, now runs, puts it up off the glass, no good. And we'll go back down the other way. And here comes McCaskey. Well, final media timeout here, ladies and gentlemen, in the William Nix Center. The Panthers are going to have to do something with it if you want to get out of here with a win. 3:25 left to play, 61-64. The Panthers down by three.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 3 minutes and 25 seconds left to play. The Panthers led by as many as 11 a couple of times in the contest, but have let the Alcorn State Braves battle back into this one. For the Braves, Jeremiah Gambrill with 19 points for the former Panther. But for the Big Dog, 22 points and 10 rebounds for Byron Miles. This is going to be his 13th double-double of the year. Javonte Hopkins providing support with 16 points. Down to 3:18. Left to play. Down low and in the corner, wide open for three. G. Willikers. and a timeout is Jeremiah Kendall. And Kendall just sat right in the corner all by himself and drew the defense into the paint. And then wide open out there for a three-pointer was Kendall. And now the Braves are up 67-61, just like that. Wow. .306 left to play. Y'all going home? Okay. Well, I want to thank LaCondria's family for coming. Y'all be careful. Wonderful to meet you. Wonderful family. Wonderful family. They're getting out of here. And they're very avid listeners of Panther Sports. They listen all the time. So we want to thank them for coming on senior night to celebrate LaCondria. McCaskey now back over to Smith. Smith to Lane, down to 15 seconds. Here comes McCaskey on the baseline with a double pump off the left side of the glass. No good. Getting close to crunch time here, folks, for the Panthers. Down by six, 67-61. Thorne works left, gives it up now to Joshua. And it's knocked out of bounds off the outstretched arms of Smith. McKinley Harris will check in for Charles Smith, folks. The Panthers will have 6 seconds on the shot clock to do something with it. Gambrell fights off. Hopkins puts it up for three. Oh, wow. Gambrell's mom's over there talking a lot of trash. And a couple of substitutions. Felix and Smith. We'll check back in for the Panthers. Harris will come out after some quality defensive minutes. Folks, we're officially in crunch time. 2 minutes left to play. And Hopkins leans in. And the Panthers will shoot two shots. Hopkins. Hopkins will be shooting two, folks. Don't forget, exciting Panther basketball continues this Monday. The season finale right here in the Baby Dome as the Panthers take on the Jackson State Tigers. They'll finish the season Saturday, or is it Thursday? Saturday against the Tigers of Texas Southern University. And then that is the ninth, which is Saturday. And then the Southwestern Athletic Conference Tournament starts at the Ball Tower Arena in Birmingham, Alabama, 13th through the 16th. Show want to go. DJ says, well, I'll be there. We're going to have to call James. And Zibby wants to get a standby cameraman and part-time Big Mouth. We'll see. Hopkins, shot is away. Ah, creeps in. 69-63, a six-point edge. Gambrill up top, left side. Thorne gives it up to Joshua. Joshua in trouble. He can't touch the ball. That should have been a double dribble. And Miles hammers. Gee whiz. So many opportunities, folks, that we're just not capitalizing on. Throwing to go to the line. Beard at the line for free throw. Second shot is away. No good. Miles almost had it knocked away. Gazelius, Nick Gazelius comes in for the Panthers. 63-70, a 7-point lead. The Panthers with time. 1:32 left to play. Hopkins comes right side. Hopkins takes a quick one in the middle off the glass. No, no. And it rolls right off. Here comes McKinley Harris in for defense. Down to a minute 14. And Hopkins has to make a decision. Hopkins picks up number four offense for defense, Charles Smith. We're doing it for the Panthers. Shot is away, it's good. Another free throw, what's going on? I don't even think they know what's happening. Shot is away, it's good. And now the Braves doing nothing but defending. McCaskey out to Charles Lane for three. No good. The Panthers in desperation now. We're under a minute to play. 9-point edge for the Braves of Alcorn State here. Bowie, or Joshua rather, just and nothing. The Panthers with the ball. Here comes Miles. And Miles will get the foul. We'll take the long walk down to 33 seconds left to play on this one. Byron Joshua, the senior from New Orleans, will be. Well, no, they're going to call that one on the Panthers. Wow. Shot is away, it's no good. Here comes McCaskey quickly up the right side and gets a quick 2-point shot. And now the Panthers down 7. Would you like a butterscotch lifesaver? That's oak. 26.5 seconds left to play. Crystal, your granddaughter is saying, I need to quit eating so much. well, whatever. Don't forget, folks, this Monday senior night here for the men at the William Nix Center. This Monday, March 4th at 7:30 p.m., we're honoring our seniors, our senior men's team. And then coming up Wednesday, softball, followed by season finale for the men's team on Saturday. And here we go. 25 seconds left to play. And a timeout by Joshua with 18 seconds left to play. Folks, thanks so much for joining us. Want to welcome back home an offensive weapon who is going to continue to be an offensive weapon, and that's our offensive coordinator, Anthony Wheat, who's coming back to the place where champions are built. Excellence lives here, and he is the epitome of excellence. Anthony Wheat got a chance to go by his office yesterday, the day before yesterday, and we got a chance to exchange pleasantries. I caught several touchdowns from Anthony Wheat. Just remember this word, chaos. And we're not talking about get smart. We'll check it out, okay? You remember get smart at least, right? Do you know who chaos is? Okay, just checking. We're not talking about a whole bunch of stuff going on either. Well, folks, man, I tell you, the Panthers had an opportunity. And my counterpart here. Here we go. Joshua, Wyatt. And a foul. Want to send a shout out to Lilette Johnson. Lilette, are you in Chicago, Illinois? I just want to say hello to you, my classmate. Shout out away, it's good. Well, 8-point lead here, 65-73, the Braves up. 10.5 seconds left to play in this one. Shot is away, it's no good. Miles to McCaskey, to Lane for three. Well, folks. Wow. Well, folks. Panthers just couldn't get it done here at the William Nix Center. 73-65, the final score. And what a tough one. We'll be right back here on Monday night as the Panthers take on the Tigers of Jackson State. 5:30 and 7:30, the tip-off. And now the school song, folks. Thank you. We're back live here, ladies and gentlemen, in the William Nixon and Charles Porter, along with head coach Byron Smith, man. Wow, coach, we were right there again. And, man, it's just was tough. We couldn't finish.
No, we don't have finishers, Charles. Good kids, they're just not finishers. I mean, not to be too hard on them, but, you know, you get a lead, 12-point lead, and you just, you know, you don't have that leadership that you need. Point guard to kind of take care of the basketball, slow us down a little bit, get us into something. A defensive leader where we just, hey, man, let's get three stops in a row. We just lacking that. And that's all in just trying to get better and trying to improve your program, and we will do that. But tough way to go out, like you said.
Yeah, Coach, I tell you, you have really, really put a lot of work into this program. And gee whiz, it's just very difficult to have an interview after this, Coach. And we're not gonna prolong it. But, you know, Coach, we'll see you Monday.
Yes.
Good luck for Monday. We play Texas Southern. Yeah. On Saturday, we get back to the drawing board, man. Yeah. We still got a lot of nucleus here. We got some great coaches.
Thank you.
I believe in you. I know what you can do.
Thank you.
We just got to get the program back to where it should be, where it belongs.
Yeah.
I mean, gee whiz, we worked so hard to get here. We can't turn back now.
Can't do that. Got to keep fighting. Adversity, you know, test your character, who you're about, what you're about. And, you know, it's some dark days right now, but the sun will come up tomorrow, and, you know, we'll live to fight another day.
Well, in the words of Charlie Wilson, Mama said there'll be days like this.
Absolutely.
Huh? I can't do the second part.
No, I can't either, I definitely understand what you're saying, but it is a difficult time for us right now, but you have to persevere. Like I said, keep fighting, keep working to get better, try to improve the program, keep doing what you've been doing, just got to go harder.
Well, I have all the confidence in you, Coach, and
of course,
I want to thank our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, as we always do as two Christian men. And thank everybody for watching us, and thank everybody for supporting us, ladies and gentlemen. Thank everybody for supporting this program. And we're doing some things to get us back to support. We're doing some things with our great AD. He's got some good programs going on. We're trying to get all of the former players back to support the program. The women showed it today as they came back next year. Start telling all of the former players that on senior day, we want all of you guys back here on campus to help support this program, and we're going to get back to where we need to be. That's going to wrap it up for us here in the William Nix Center with Coach Byron Smith. Any final thoughts?
Hey, man, you know, again, just got to hang in there. Appreciate the support, you know, for the ones who do support and the ones that don't, start supporting, like you say. And, you know, I'm a fighter, and that's all I know is to keep fighting. And this is, you know, in coaching, you know, I always say, you know, you have success, then you don't have success. You have to kind of hit the reset button a little bit, but there's purpose. So the purpose and the goal and the challenge, because we're motivated by challenges as humans, the challenge is to get this program back to where we had it a few years ago, and I'm confident that we can do that, and we will do that.
Absolutely, ladies and gentlemen. Well, that's going to wrap it up for us here in the William Nix Center. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank everyone who made this possible and say congratulations again to the women's basketball team who celebrated their four-peat championship during today's halftime. I want to thank our friends over at Woodlawn Entertainment, Mr. Donald Carroll, of course, James Crenshaw, the big dog. Also, I want to thank Mia Greer, my assistant, who did such a fantastic job. Kiki is the best stat passer outer in America, and we want to thank you for that. For our athletic director, Mr. Anton Goff, our senior women administrator and associate athletic director, Ms. Alicia Pete, and also our boss, LaTanya Thurston. This is Charles Porter and Rick Godfrey saying so long. We'll see you next week, or Monday, actually, with more exciting Panther basketball. Good night.